Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallama wa baraka ala nabiyyina wa habibina wa qudwatina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawmiddin. Wa ba'd. Dear brothers, sisters, friends, and family, I hope you're all well and protected. Inshallah, I hope that inshallah spending time together is creating new bonds, new memories, and developing a better relationship. Dear friends, yes, I'm referring to my youth. You know, people who are in colleges, universities, schools. My specially Thursday talks are for you. They are targeted for you. Inshallah, this is a series called Rewind, where we want to discuss some of the aspects of the lives of our pious predecessors known as Salaf al-Salihun. Dear brothers and sisters, every nation has a history, right? And we, being Muslims, we have a tradition which is 1400 years old. You know, subhanAllah, there have been people in our history who made a very significant impact on our society. The reason why we want to share their stories or some of their life aspects is because so we can take some lessons, some inspirations. People always take inspirations from their role models. And you know, subhanAllah, if we were connected with our history, we do have a lot of role models. And you know, subhanAllah, their stories truly shakes a person's iman. And it encourages us. It encourages us to further carry on their legacy, carry on the legacy of our tradition forward towards the next generations. So, for this purpose, every Thursday, dear brothers and sisters, I do want to share something from our past, some story from our past, and so that we can take lessons and, you know, we can get inspired to do good. You know, subhanAllah, these people lived centuries ago, but their mention is still up to this day. You know, we talk about them up until this day. They lived on as if they have never passed away. They have lived on, you know, in our memories. You know, subhanAllah, when we pass away, will we be forgotten in history, or will people remember us for something significant that perhaps we have done? And remember, bringing benefit to the society, it is one of the best acts of worship a person can do. And this is part and parcel of our beautiful deen, the religion of Islam. So, without any further ado, dear brothers and sisters, today I want to talk about a person who lived in the second century of Islam. This person happened to be known as, and the titles given to this person was Shaykh al-Hijaz, Shaykh al-Islam, the scholar of Hijaz. Hijaz is a region of Mecca, Medina, and Jeddah. That whole area is known as Hijaz. He was given the title as Shaykh al-Islam, the scholar of Islam. But his life does not start with piety. His life does not start with righteousness. SubhanAllah, in his youth, in his early years during his life, he was famously known as the highway robber. And yes, I'm talking about a person named Fudail ibn Iyad. Again, Fudail ibn Iyad. You know, any student of Islamic sciences and especially hadith sciences would know very well of him and his contribution to that field. So Fudail ibn Iyad, he was famously known as the highway robber, a person who was shatir, who used to stand in the pathways and in the highways and take people's and loot people's belongings. SubhanAllah, that is how his life started early on. It happened so, and the story that I want to mention is one day he was climbing the walls of a house to get to a person that he had fallen in love with. You know, subhanAllah, I just want you to pause here. Temptations and sense, they have always been attracted. They're always, they always look very, you know, subhanAllah, something that we want to do. And shaitan said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَأُزَيِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ, I will entice them towards sins. You know, people have been tested before us as well with temptations. And you know, if you are a youth listening to this, you could relate to this. You know, subhanAllah, temptations, we are surrounded with them. But how do we manage our desires? How do we control our desires? And how do we make sure our desires are channeled in the right way possible? So he was climbing the walls in order to reach the room of a person he had fallen in love with. And while he was climbing the walls, he heard this verse being recited. أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. Has the time not come for the believers, people who have believed, that their hearts tremble with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Just one verse that was recited was so powerful on him that he abandoned. He came down and he said, Bala ya Rab. Of course, he interacted with this verse. Again, the verse was talking about, has the time not come for the believers that their hearts tremble with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, of course, O Allah. And he came down and he went to a shelter, a deserted shelter, you know, to contemplate on the events that had happened that night. And he contemplated and reflected hard of what was happening. And he was talking to himself. And he was saying, subhanAllah, it is right now time for me to change my ways. As he was talking to himself, he heard a group of people behind him talking. And they were travelers. And they were debating whether they should carry on with their travel or whether they should spend the night here. And some people were saying they should spend the night because there is a famous highway robber known as Fudayl ibn Iyad. And there are chances he would be out tonight and there is a possibility he could bring us some harm. So to avoid him, we should stay in the shelter. While Fudayl ibn Iyad, he's listening to this conversation. Again, he talks to himself. He said, perhaps for this reason, Allah has brought me here so that I can take heed, I can take a lesson, and I can change my ways. And narrations have it that he turned to that group and he said, I'm Fudayl ibn Iyad, and I've announced that I'm changing my ways and I've truly repented back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he took a vow and he took a promise with Allah as a condition of his repentance that he would go to his house, i.e. Makkah al-Mukarramah, and spend the rest of his life there in service of knowledge and learning from others and conveying this knowledge to others. Dear brothers and sisters, the point of this is not just storytelling, but the point is, isn't it time now for us to truly know Allah? Isn't it time now for us to reflect upon our lives, to contemplate on our lives, to ask ourselves, what do we want to do in this world? What kind of impact I want to make in this world? So, you know, subhanAllah, from a highway robber to one of the esteemed scholars of his time, whose mention is still remembered and talked about today. You know, subhanAllah, amongst his students, people he taught were the names of Sufyan ibn Uyayna, who was the teacher of famous Imam Bukhari, who compiled the Sahih of al-Bukhari. You know, dear brothers and sisters, just reflect on this fact. Isn't it time? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put us in a very different situation. Isn't it time that we take advantage of the situation? Reflect. Think about what were the things that I was doing in my past. How will I proceed forward? How should I mend my ways? What kind of relationship should I develop with my Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You know, we are at home. Most of us are at home. And, you know, most of us are having a very difficult time thinking about what will happen after this crisis, this pandemic is over. So I want you to plan, take this opportunity to reflect and see which trajectory, which direction you want your life to move in. And you know, once you decide that, come up with a plan and ask yourselves, how can you do, can you make this world a better place? How, through your religion, through Islam, you can carry forward that legacy which these pious predecessors left behind, and how you can make an impact in this world, and what part can you play so that your name carries on even generations after you pass away. These are the inspirations we need to take from these stories. These are the lessons that we need to take from these stories. And as I mentioned, inshallah, every Thursday, you know, from now until Ramadan, I will bring you these stories so that you and I both can take lessons and we can contemplate, reflect, and plan our lives, you know, to live our lives in a way that has the most meaning to it while staying true to our beautiful deen of Islam. In conclusion, I hope you are well and I hope you're spending your time in doing something productive. I hope, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make things, affairs easy for you. You know, subhanallah, I completely understand some of our youth are in the midst of, you know, not knowing what will happen with their studies, with their higher education. I hope I make dua that Allah makes things easy and affairs easy for all of us. Jazakumullahu khairan for tuning in. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.